माननीय सभासद, माननीय सभापति जी,
स्टेटमेंट रिगार्डिंग गवर्नमेंट बिजनेस, श्री मुख्तार अब्बास नकवी।
सर, विद योर परमिशन, आई राइज टू अनाउंस द गवर्नमेंट बिजनेस फॉर दिस वीक विल कंसिस्ट द फॉलोइंग आइटम, कंसीडरेशन एंड पासिंग ऑफ द फॉलोइंग बिल पास बाय द लोकसभा, शेड्यूल कास्ट शेड्यूल ट्राइब प्रिवेंशन एंड अमेंडमेंट बिल 2014, अप्रोप्रिएशन एक्ट रिपील बिल 2015, रिपीलिंग एंड अमेंडिंग बिल 2015, विसिल ब्लोअर प्रोटेक्शन बिल 2015, फॉर कंसीडरेशन एंड पासिंग ऑफ द जुवेनाइल जस्टिस अमेंडमेंट बिल 2015, फॉर फर्दर कंसीडरेशन एंड पासिंग ऑफ द प्रिवेंशन ऑफ करप्शन अमेंडमेंट बिल 2013, कंसीडरेशन एंड पासिंग ऑफ द चाइल्ड लेबर अमेंडमेंट बिल 2012, कंसीडरेशन एंड पासिंग ऑफ द नेगोशिएबल इंस्ट्रूमेंट अमेंडमेंट बिल 2015, कंसीडरेशन एंड पासिंग ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल 122nd अमेंडमेंट बिल 2014, कंसीडरेशन एंड पासिंग ऑफ द रियल इस्टेट बिल 2013।
थैंक यू। थैंक यू नकवी जी। ऑनरेबल मेंबर्स, नाउ वी रिज्यूम द डिस्कशन विच वाज स्टार्टेड ऑन Friday. The first speaker is Kumari Mayawati ji.
Sir, हमने request की है, वेंकैया जी थोड़ा बोलेंगे
जी,
उसके बाद मायावती जी।
हाँ, बोल सकते हैं
वेंकैया जी, please sir.
लोकसभा में जाना बाद में, इसलिए otherwise I would have been happy to hear. Sir, Chairman sir, thank you for giving me this opportunity. In fact, I was there in the Lok Sabha during the debate on constitution or commitment to constitution and also 125th birth anniversary of Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar. Later I thought I should also speak in my house because I thought I should put my point of view before all the seniors there in the Rajya Sabha. My idea is little different from others, sir. As a Parliamentary Affairs Minister, I must admit that I have taken initiative. I talked to some of our colleagues also. The suggestion came from one of the members from the opposition there, and about the observing the Constitutional Day and making it a regular feature. And subsequently, I received some letters from some political parties, including our colleague from the CPM, Sitaram Yechury, about celebrating Ambedkar Jayanti in a big way. Of debates also on what Ambedkar ji wanted and what is happening and what is the affirmative action from the government, like that he wrote a letter also. Then we discussed and then we came to the conclusion, let us have both together, our commitment to the constitution and then celebration of Ambedkar Jayanti. Let us devote first, some people suggested one day, then later 2 days and all. That's why we are discussing it. In Rajya Sabha we could not have the discussion on that day because unfortunately one of our honorable members has expired. So this Article 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 concerning citizenship, Article 60 concerning presidents of India, Article 324, 366, 367, 379, 380, 388, 391, 392 and 393, they all came into force on November 26, 1949 itself, before the January 26, 1950, because they were necessary even to proceed further. Keeping that in mind, our constitutional framers at that time have brought in all this, and the remaining provisions, that is major part of the constitution, came into force on January 26, 1950. In between, people had further discussions, and then they have ratified it on 26th January, and then rechristened it as the Republic Day. We are all proud to observe the Republic Day also. But the day of the commencement of the constitution is also equally important. Though officially they said 26th January, the 26th November, the day the report was submitted, it is also equally important. And then today we are discussing both together. So keeping that in mind, I have certain views in mind. The idea is to express our gratitude, remember the great work done by the father of the nation, Mahatma Gandhi, and the architects of the modern India, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, then the unifier of India, Sardar Vallabhai Patel, the first education minister, one of the stalwarts of India those days, Maulanaji, and then other, our president of the Constituent Assembly. First president was Sarachandra Sinha, subsequently Dr. Rajendra Prasad. We have to recollect the great work done by these great people and also visit the Constitution and remember the great contribution and the great thoughts and great expectations that have come from the Constitution and the speeches in the Constituent Assembly. That's the purpose. Keeping that in mind, sir, we are focusing more on Ambedkar because of the invaluable contribution he has made as the chairman of the drafting committee of the Constituent Assembly. And we are also remembering the good contribution made by 271 or so members who are all responsible for bringing such a value addition to the Constitution. So, my ideas, I am speaking as a member. Though I am a Parliamentary Affairs Minister, I am also speaking as a member. My ideas is, what is there in the Constitution, I need not explain something. What has been said by others also, I have taken note of it. My idea is that this is a time that we should really remember what was the expectation of these founding fathers of the Constitution, how far we have achieved, how far we have travelled, what are the grey areas, what are the shortcomings, what are the challenges before us, then how do you meet those challenges? Let there be a broad consensus, or let there be divergent opinion, let the public opinion go on moulding in its own way. That is the purpose according to me. So our contribution, rather than saying that your government is responsible to this extent, this government is responsible to this extent, my government is responsible to this extent and all, these debates of course that goes on continuously. And we have bills and we have different topics to be discussed in the house, we can devote time, but this is the time to take stock of the situation and then try to move forward. How far we have gone forward, that's the issue. So keeping that in mind, what I am thinking is that the founding fathers of the Constitution, they wanted to have the respect to the constitutional institutions, all constitutional sense in the parliament, judiciary, and also the other institutions of the India, how far we have strengthened them. Keeping the unity and integrity of our country and its democratic, socialist and secular character, to what extent we have achieved it. Maintaining transparency, probity and accountability in public life. Dedicate ourselves to equality and social justice and contribute to the task of building a strong republic. These are the expectations of the founding fathers. So, to what extent we have reached it? What are the views of Dr. Ambedkar on caste? He said caste is anti-national, if I have read him correctly. And what are we doing? Are we doing justice to this? Are we not basing some of our politics on the basis of caste? Some of our politics on the basis of religion? Some of our politics based on the region? This is one issue everyone has to ponder over. And then secondly, Ambedkar wanted to have uniformity of law, civil as well as criminal also. After so many years of experience, have we done justice in that direction? Is there uniformity of civil laws? Are we in a position to talk about and accept and work out the modalities of a common law with regard to marriage, inheritance? With regard to marriage, inheritance and divorce and maintenance? No, so far we have not been able to do it. Whatever may be the reason, I am not saying only particular law should prevail, Hindu law should prevail or this law should prevail and all. I am not into that. Have we made attempts to move in that direction in spite of Supreme Court saying it a number of times? In spite of public opinion also, and in spite of the fact that in a state like Goa, there is a common civil code, there is no practically no problem, different communities are living in harmony there. We have also have the Shabanu verdict of the Honorable Supreme Court. What has happened subsequently? We have amended it also, the Parliament has amended the law. Have we done justice? To what extent it has helped us? Or has it hurt? What is about gender equity, gender equality? Have you done justice to gender equality? Are the women of different, woman is a woman. She may be a Hindu, she may be Muslim or a Christian or some other religion, but woman is woman. Is there gender equality? Have we made some attempts in that direction? If somebody is criticized, there will be people always criticize, sir. Some people with opposite reservation also, at that time also. saying that by reservations you are dividing Hindu society. That was the argument at that time. But still, our seniors in their collective wisdom have gone for reservations. And then the question of sub-reservations, that is also an urgent issue. The purpose of reservation is to reach the needy, uplift the poorest of the poor, take care of the suppressed, oppressed and depressed people. That was the purpose of reservation. And have we done justice to that? Then the question of ABCD among the backward classes, the question of now debate going on in the Dalits also about AB. In my area, that area at least, I remember, people are vehemently agitating on both sides. Some people don't want it, some people want it. They are saying if the purpose is reservation is to help the needy, there has to be justice to different sections of the same community, because we have castes and subcastes also in this country. To what extent we have moved it? The Andhra Pradesh government have passed a law giving a reservation for subcastes, scheduled caste Mala and Madiga. Subsequently, it's followed by late N.T. Ramarao. Then the matter went up to Supreme Court. Supreme Court has struck down it. Unless, without amending the constitution, you can't do this. That was the judgment of the Supreme Court. Then Usha Mahara committee has been appointed. They made certain recommendations. The agitation is going on. Wherever you go, all politicians of different views, people come and they protest, and then they sometimes create disturbance in the meetings also. But still, we are not able to take a call. With regard to women's reservation, it's a women's reservation, all parties on the face of it, on record, everybody is in favor of women's reservation. But it's not happening. Why? People should explain now. If I say that why it has not happened in 10 years, then the debate will be 10 years if yours you have not done. Then you will say that you were there during earlier Vajpayee's regime, you have not done it. I am not into that today. I am not into that. Can we collectively, at least now, as a tribute to the founding fathers, can we do justice? There is a reservation for women in local bodies in different parts of the country. 50% reservation is doing well in certain areas. Now, there is a request for reservation of 33%.
Please.
Bob, question is, who is in Lok Sabha? Before we go to Parlok Sabha, better we do something now. I am not saying you, we. So my point is, let us be very frank. Let us not be hypocritical. But when I discuss with my colleagues, they are saying, Santaram, please. Santaramji, please. Point is, when I discuss with my colleagues of all shades, they say, you want us to sign the death warrant on our Rajasthan, Lok Sabha? Out of Lok Sabha 543, you want 33% people to go and all male benches to be vacant. But at the same time, when you talk to lady members, they say, how long you go on talking like this? The other day, all party meeting, friends have suggested to me, at least you have not brought it in the agenda. Keval agenda mein rakhne mein matlab kya hai? Bahut vishay agenda mein the 50 saal se. Magar jab kar payenge tabhi na, is beech mein aapas mein charcha karke, bhai 33% kare, nahi to aur koi beech ka rasta hai kya? The movement is a beech ka rasta, then again, Mr. Vengaya Naidu want to dilute the women's reservation 33%. Then there will be a statement. Then again, we'll say, no, we are for 33%. Then who is not for 33%? Why things are not moving? This is another issue. Sir, we have a challenge about the regional disparities. There are certain regions which are backward in the country, certain regions are backward. Then we have demands for creation of new states. We created new states of Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand and Uttarakhand. Subsequently, we created Telangana. Then at that time also, there was demands that particular region, even I myself standing here, in the Dr. Sabha sitting here. And then I demanded that Andhra should be given special status because they are losing revenue. Subsequently, number of states are also asking for special status. The next day in Parliament, I very well remember, the next day in Parliament after the bill was passed, there was discussion, Orissa wanted it, Bihar wanted it, West Bengal wanted it, and even Tamil Nadu, one of the developed states, they were also saying, now a lot of Punjabi now asking. Almost, I don't think they know a state. And that is the flavor of the season now. Every region want to be backward region. Every caste want to be backward. And backward want to be most backward. And then most backward wanted to be included in scheduled caste. And some people wanted to be scheduled tribe. This is going on. I am not trying to find fault with them, sir. It is social aspirations. So with the advent of all these maturity that is coming up, people are asking for more things. So how do you reconcile that? Should we not prepare certain guidelines? Then with regard to the issue of special status, what was the Godgill formula? What is the 14th Finance Commission recommendation? Then how do you move forward? We have to evolve a broad consensus. Simply saying that, oh, no, you, then I say, why you have not put in the law? They say, Prime Minister has given an assurance on the floor of the House. Well, Prime Minister or ex-Prime Minister is not the issue. The assurance has been given in the House. I do agree. It's I who suggested to Dr. Saab, Manmohan Singh Ji, that in view of the fact that Andhra is foregoing revenue because Hyderabad is given to Telangana rightly, so there will be loss of revenue, Andhra has to be given special status. Because special status, other categories do not apply to Andhra Pradesh, like hilly area, forest area, or border area, etc. That do not apply to Andhra Pradesh. The only issue is Andhra Pradesh, the loss of revenue. But now the situation is, after the 14th Finance Commission and then request by so many states and all, easily my friend Ramesh can, Jairam Ramesh can tell me, no, you first you have given a commitment, give it to Andhra Pradesh, fine. Is it going to end there? That's another issue. So I feel even today, though I am a member, but the national level I am a minister, I still feel injustice has been done to Andhra Pradesh and we have to separate it in what manner, special status or special assistance. Well, the finance ministry is looking into that. But point is, unless you are able to evolve some sort of a broad consensus, it is difficult to move on the direction, one. Secondly, sir, as I told you, common civil code. Common civil code also, the movement, some people are confusing common civil code to Hindu civil code, which is not. Even Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar also has favored it. It is a common, which is commonly good in different personal laws, that has to be taken out and then we have to go for a common civil code. That we are yet to achieve it. That would have brought some more national integration also, according to me. Even now, I feel that that should be discussed also, threadbare, not to keep in elections in mind and all. With regard to minority and majority, at the end of the day, Dr. Ambedkarji, I don't have that much time to quote him elaborately, sir. He wanted this minority and majority should be forgotten after some time and they should all merge together. And people of India, irrespective of caste, creed, sex, religion, region, we are one nation, we are one people. We must have one law. That is the concept of the founding fathers of the Constitution. We are not able to move towards that. We have not made any sincere attempts also. Why, whatever party is in power, that's a different matter. You have been in 50 years, we have been earlier in 5-6 years, and now again, we are going to be there for another 5 to 10 years. We don't know. People are, they will decide. But point is, sir, unless there is a consensus, unless there is a consensus, difficult to go. Now, we have seen after debate for years, the parliament in its collective wisdom has passed a law, unanimous law on the appointment of judges to the judiciary. The Supreme Court has struck down it. Supreme Court has struck down. And then there is also argument that there is no scheduled caste proper representation. And there is no scheduled caste representation even with regard to the senior bureaucracy, IAS. Really, it's really a very... I said it. So this is also an issue. Without directly asking for reservation, there should be some affirmative action to see that the social justice is done so that these sections also feel that they also have a stake in the system, which we have not done for whatever reason it is, without making that an issue. But the Supreme Court has struck down. I don't know. I am not an expert on that, though I have studied law, but I could not practice it. And Jatleji is there. There are other experts also. Dr. Ravi Shankar Prasad also is sitting behind me. The point is, Parasaranji is also sitting here. Very, very important issue. Nobody is willing to open up. Few voices come up. And then we are trying to score political points that we have drafted a bad law. We have collectively discussed in this House. We have all came to the conclusion. Then the House in its collective wisdom has passed, except one or two people. Others, nobody has objected to. Almost all the major political parties are one with this. Nowhere, I read Arunji's this thing, nowhere in the world, judges appoint themselves. I don't think any other system also. But it is a situation today. It is a situation today. And is everything fine? Then why should there be a discussion about changing the collegium system? So that is an issue wherein I thought in this debate of this 2 days or 3 days, whatever it is, people focus their attention on that. And then how do you get? Then there is also regional aspirations, sir. Regional aspirations. Some people are very comfortable. But we come from different parts of the country. There is a feeling, why not a bench of the Supreme Court in southern part of the country? Why should the litigant travel all the way for ordinary cases to up to Delhi? What is happening? Why, what is the great constitutional difficulty in that? I am not able to understand. I am not making any commentary on the functioning or the attitude of the Supreme Court of India. There are other seniors. Why can't we do it? After all, it is an administrative mechanism, what we are suggesting. What we are suggesting. Then with regard to the delay, with regard to cases also, how much time it's taking, and how suddenly some important cases are getting priority. This is also a question, sir, that is debate among the ordinary people. Some cases suddenly get priority at the top level also. But the ordinary cases, common man cases, they are not getting priority. This is another issue which is agitating the minds of the people. Keeping that in mind, we have to focus our attention on how to take care of the regional disparities, one. Then we come with the backward area development fund. Every district which is forward also is saying, I am also backward. And no political party is able to say, no, you are not backward. That means then you will be backward among the votes also. That's also another point. I'm sorry, Chairman sir, I was kind enough to permit me, and Nayaji was kind enough to accede to my request because I have to go there. I'm speaking out of my heart. Certain issues, having come to this level, after 68 years of independence, if you are not able to address these genuine concerns which are agitating the minds and which was the expectation of our forefathers, we are not able to do that for whatever reason it is. And we are trying to score political points. Aapka jamana mein aisa ho gaya, fir mai kahunga tumhara jamana mein kya hua dekho. Aap mere se zyada samay chalaya. Aapka kya sthiti hai? Aur then latest is now about these books, about the question of tolerance, etc. I'm happy that Sri Chidambaram has one of our intelligent person belonging to the intelligentsia, he said that it was wrong on our part to ban Salman Rushdie's book. Sir, there are two things. One is the people who are writing books, they should not affect the sentiment of the people. They should not arouse social tensions. But at the same time, about the freedom of expression and freedom of speech, then people have got right. But there has to be a broad consensus about how do you go about it. You ban Salman Rushdie's book, then you feel happy. If somebody bans Shivaji's book, then there is protest. And then in that also, different angles are coming. Hindu, Muslim angle, this angle or that angle. Let there be a policy to go about with regard to banning of books or banning of films also. Even with regard to censor also, debate is going on. All these things have not happened overnight, sir. All these things have not happened overnight after Mr. Narendra Modi has become Prime Minister. These things have been agitating. These things have been happening in different parts of the country. I am not trying to justify anything. The atrocities on Dalit, are they happening now? Yeah, Dalit family was burnt. The Thara Chand, I think, his daughter were burnt. In which regime? I am not getting into that. In which regime? I am not getting into that. And then writers were also killed in certain, were killed in two places. Under whose regime? That's not the issue. Issue is there is some amount of intolerance in the society in different areas. So that has to be identified. It has to be localized. It has to be dealt firmly. Instead of that, we are trying to make it generalized. And then which will in turn show India in a poor light, which is not in our national interest. Keep that in mind. And then after tolerance debate that is going to take place in the House, there are other seniors who will talk on that. I am only appealing, let us all tolerant to each other. And then tolerant towards the verdict of the people. Sir, according to me, the biggest tolerance that has to be shown, the respect that has to be shown to the Constitution is respecting the mandate of the people. Respecting the mandate of the people. X has been mandated to rule Tamil Nadu. Y has been mandated to rule West Bengal. Another one is mandated to rule Bihar. Now people of Bihar have mandated Nitish Kumarji, with the support of Laluji, to rule Bihar. We have to respect it. Whether you like it or not, that's not an issue. You have no choice also. But you respect in Bihar, but I don't respect in Delhi. So Delhi ke liye, Gali ke liye bhi ek hi name ho, ek hi name hoga. So this also, according to me, is one of the important aspects of the public life, that there has to be respect for the verdict of the people. One, according to me, sir, respect to the other man's belief. Respect, I don't believe, for example, sir, I was president of the BJP. I don't believe in Vastu. I don't believe in Jyotish Shastra. But I respect both. The reason is people are free. Who are you to dictate them? People are free. But I will not practice, sir. I don't see, I don't know in north what is the system in the south. People see Rahu Kalam, saying this is a bad time, you should not move. Then I also ask them, suppose if somebody says that I'll give 1 crore rupees to you only during that period, are you not going to accept it? But at the same time, ridiculing it. And then ridiculing it. Or badnaam kare unko, provoke kare, unko feelings hurt kare. Matlab kya hai? You don't believe, na? Okay, you don't follow. If others are following it, then you just respect others' belief also. This sort of a mutual respect will only bring tolerance. In world over, sir, duniya bhar mein, alag-alag pradesho mein, alag-alag desho mein, alag-alag samay pe, kuch na kuch hote rahe. So-called great civilization, America, the other day we have seen one fellow belonging to one race, went to the college and then shot down 9 people. Mercilessly, on the basis of the color of the skin. This country, great countries are known for tolerance for years together, according to me. All of us, and some people making out of turn statements, sometimes meaningless statements. We have to condemn it. We have to isolate them. And you say that, no, that so-and-so has spoken like, what is it? कुछ लोग हमारे इस देश में पाकिस्तान से जाके पाकिस्तान से भी अनुरोध किया हम नहीं कर पा रहे भारत देश में आप आके मोदी को हटाओ वगैरह मतलब क्या है इसमें होता बट कैन यू से नहीं उन्होंने कहा है तो करने को करना बस डिजोन करना उनको जी पाकिस्तान में जाके बताने की जरूरत क्या है जी
प्लीज
पाकिस्तान में जाके बताने की जरूरत क्या है
तो माय वेंकैया जी यू माइट एग्जॉस्ट योर पार्टीज रिमेनिंग टाइम
सर माय पार्टी हैज आई थिंक रिमेनिंग टाइम ऑफ 3.5 इयर्स सर आई रिक्वेस्ट यू टू बेयर विथ मी फॉर सम लिटिल मोर टाइम बिकॉज़ व्हेन आई वाज इन अपोजिशन इफ आई रेज इश्यूज No taker. If I have a government, I keep quiet. Then I don't get broad consensus and support from others. I have to work to bring broad consensus. Then the question of the amendment to the legislators. Big debate. Sir, you are our chair and you also should understand the agony of the people. People give us lectures from outside. ये क्या है एमपीस का क्या हो रहा है इनका वेतन ये हो गया है तो इसमें कैंटीन में ऐसा खा रहे हैं एज इफ एमपीस आर ऑल गोइंग एंड ईटिंग और मुफ्त में खा रहे हैं वहाँ ऐसा नहीं है दैट कैन बी एन इश्यू पीपल हैव गॉट अ राइट बट एट सेम टाइम व्हाट अबाउट द पीपल हु आर गिविंग अस दिस प्रवचन हाउ मच इज बीइंग स्पेंट ऑन देम हाउ मच दे आर ड्रॉइंग दीज आर द इश्यूज एंड वी सर नाउ वेयर दिस व्हाट इज दिस पे कमीशन गिवन रिपोर्ट इट इज टाइम नाउ वी एवॉल्व सर आई वॉज देर इन विप्स कॉन्फ्रेंस इन विशाखपट्टनम एंड ऑल्सो इन गोवा लास्ट इयर गोवा दिस इयर इन विशाखपट्टनम वेयर इन द सजेशन हैज कम इंस्टेड ऑफ लीविंग इट टू द हाउस फ्रॉम टाइम टू टाइम टू डिस्कस एंड डिसाइड अबाउट द सैलरीज ऑफ द एमपीज लेट इट बी रेफर टू ए मेकानिज्म वेयर इन लाइक पे कमीशन ऑटोमेटिकली डिपेंडिंग ऑन नाउ द प्राइज राइज एटसेट्रा सम मेकानिज्म हैज टू इवॉल्व एंड ऑन दैट ऑल्सो वी आर फील शाइ When we are in government, we feel shy. When we go to opposition, we try to be vocal. That is the position. We are all understanding it also. So we have to be some realistic understanding on such matters also and speak with one voice. The other day, Delhi Chief Minister was telling me, Venkaiah ji, I just moved a bill only for 50,000 rupees for MP, MLA. And people started criticizing me. Do you expect people to have the maintenance with 50,000 rupees? Kitna usme se kya problem hoga wagera wagera. But so keeping that all in mind, sir, what I'm trying to say is that let us try to evolve broad consensus. As far as the government is concerned, government is trying to translate the thoughts and also the teachings and preachings for the constitutional framers with regard to federal system, with regard to devolution of funds from 32% to 42%, with regard to social security schemes like Jan Dhan Yojana, Janashri Bhima Yojana, Pradhan Mantri Pension Yojana, Atal Pension Yojana, and also the Mudra. All these things, government. The government, you may say that Mr. Venkaiah Naidu gave a charitable speech without saying what the government is doing. That's why I'm saying it. Otherwise, I would not have touched it also. Sir, this abhi election hai nahi. Abhi election bhi nahi hai, correction bhi nahi hai. Selection bhi nahi hai. Keval hum log aapas mein charcha kar rahe. I request members to please bear with me. I am speaking from the bottom of my heart. Not to score political points on anybody. If I have to score political points, I have many. I have many, but I don't want to go to that. What I am trying to say is that these days, we should really ponder over where we are lacking, where are the shortcomings, where are the challenges, then how do you address, what are the ways and means to go about it. The government and opposition, they must have a dialogue and they must try to evolve consensus. Whatever I say, that alone should be accepted. It cannot be. In a democracy, either consensus or you have to go by the majority point of view. That has been. Barabar mein bahut karke dikhaya bhai, aap chinta mat karo, bahut karke dikhaya, aage bhi karke dikhayenge. But point is, at one stage, we must break the ice. Parliament is not functioning. That's the worry of the people. Parliament is not functioning. That's the worry of the people. Who is responsible? That's secondary. People are not concerned. The last session, we could not have meaningful and fruitful discussion. Earlier session, we did wonders. Rajya Sabha did wonders also. So these are the issues that are really agitating. And the best way is, let us debate, discuss and decide. I, as a government, I propose, as an opposition, if you want to, you oppose. You need not suppose. Let the house dispose. That should be the attitude at the end of the day. That should be the system on which the parliamentary democracy has to function, sir. You know, some of my friends are not able to tolerate this because for whatever reason it is. But my suggestion is that to celebrate both the commitment to the Constitution and the birth anniversary of the great son of this great country, Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar, the real tribute is to see that their vision is followed up. The great man said two things, sir. Today he talked about socialism. He said, but people have got a right at a later stage, if they want to have an alternative method, it is free for them. He said it also. See the vision, the suffering he had, with all the suffering, insult and all, still the man has not shown any prejudice in the drafting. That's the greatness of that man. Such a great man, such a great intellectual. We should all really proud of him. उस डिबेट वो वहाँ से हटके आपने पहले स्टैचू नहीं बनाया हमने बनाया आपने चित्र नहीं लगाया हमने चित्र लगाया इससे ज़्यादा ट्रिब्यूट नहीं होगा आपसे हमने ज़्यादा काम किया करेंगे ऐसा कह के उसी दिशा में आगे बढ़ने के लिए प्रयास करना चाहिए और वी शुड ट्राई टू कम आउट ऑफ दिस कैस्ट रीजनल रिलीजियस दिस थिंग जस्टिस टू ऑल एंड अपीजमेंट ऑफ नन शुड बी अवर पॉलिसी ऑन दोज लाइन्स इफ देर इज अ डिस्कशन एंड इफ देर इज एट लीस्ट ऑन सर्टन
Please, 1 minute. No, please, he has not conceded.
No, I can, sir, no problem.
I just wanted the Honorable Parliamentary Affairs Minister to explain there are a lot of bills pending regarding the one of the noble ideals to achieve equality. That is, the bills which are pending before the government. Is the Honorable Minister to achieve the noble ideals, is willing to get those bills passed. Please explain.
Sir, bills can be passed. If there is a will, the bill can go forward. if there is tolerance, then the parliament can function. And if the parliament functions, then collective wisdom we can pass. He raised a pertinent point. I'm not trying to make light of him. The other day, even I heard of Mayawati ji also earlier, also in the earlier session and all. Even on those issues of affirmative action also, with regard to atrocities and scheduled caste, scheduled tribe, with regard to the promotion in reservation, which was accepted during Atal Bihari Vajpayee's period also. So, yeah, I'm just coming. And what happened subsequently? Is there a consensus on that? We have seen our friends from Uttar Pradesh and also from Bihar, from other this thing, and people from other communities, backward classes, they express certain concerns. Let me be very frank. Let me be frank, sir, with regard to promotion in reservation. Reservation in promotion. Certain apprehensions have been expressed. Let us understand that. And even in women's reservation also, certain people have brought in, why is the reservation for the backward class? It will be only forward caste, Mahila and all. So these are the issues, critical issues. That's the demand for reservation in the private sector. Is there a broad consensus on that? The government brings bills on base of two things. One is by way of broad consultation. Second is by way of the commitment of the government in that direction. But simply bringing the bills and getting them defeated in the House are showing to the country and giving a message that the house is divided even on such a sensitive issue. I don't think it's going to solve any problem. Ultimately, government has to move in the right direction. As Dr. Ambedkar ji has visualized at the time.
All right, it's now, this is not the subject on the moment. Pankaj ji, have you finished?
Sir, I'm just finishing, sir. So, I as a Parliamentary Affairs Minister always remind my cabinet colleagues, whenever something comes here in the house, I convey it to them. Because in our system, we have a collective responsibility. They have to study various implications, legal implications, legislative measures to be brought in. And then also we have private dialogue, informal dialogue also with people. And then at the end of it, then legislations come here. It's not because simply Venkaiah Naidu wants this bill to come tomorrow, it will not come. That has to be through a system. Whenever something happens, something is said about these certain aspects, I always take notes for information I'm telling you. I try to pass it on. Sometimes about the sugar cane problem, recently we discussed a big way, Saraji has given certain suggestions. We took it in cabinet twice and then finally came to certain conclusions with regard to that also. And then on issues of Sri Lankan fishermen, sir, I'm just sorry to, Sri Lankan fishermen. Tamil fishermen, we are being arrested and harassed by Sri Lanka from time to time. Government of India is taking steps, but what is the permanent solution? Is it happening first time after Narendra Modi became Prime Minister? It was there earlier to 10 years of UPA, earlier before that also of NDA, earlier before that also. So some sort of permanent solution has to be found. Otherwise, every session we raise it because we have to show to the people that we are concerned about your problems and all, and we are satisfying ourselves. But the issue is not getting resolved. I come from that part of the country, and I also raised the issue in House as an opposition member, and as a government also, from time to time, we discuss, and Prime Minister has taken initiative, wherein he got 5 people who have been convicted for life. They have been released at the initiative of our Honorable Prime Minister. So, to conclude, sir, the government led by Sri Narendra Modi is...
Please,
Professor, don't. Professor Alexei Premkumar was kidnapped by Taliban. Prime Minister got involved and got him released. Thousands of people who are holed up in different parts of the country whenever there is a crisis in those countries. मैं बता रहा हूँ ना नेपाल का भी समाधान करने के लिए सरकार प्रयास कर रहे हैं एक तरफ से होगा नहीं ऐसा नाजुक मामलों को पॉलिटिकलाइज करने में कोई मतलब नहीं है उससे कोई सॉल्यूशन निकलने हमारे नहीं है आप बताइए क्या करना जरूर देखेंगे मधेशी वालों का समस्या है वो गंभीर समस्या है मगर वो विदेश में है विषय तो ये मधेशी का और वो विदेशी का दोनों मिलके स्वदेशी में हम लोग क्या तय करें उसके पॉलिसी उसके बारे में भी चर्चा करना चाहिए सर आई एम ओनली कंक्लूडिंग बाय सेइंग दैट द हाउस शुड आफ्टर द एंड ऑफ द डिबेट टुडे being concluded by the Prime Minister, we should come out with a categorical resolution wherein we should reaffirm Manasa, Vacha, and then try to move Karmana, Sahit, and then we should try to move in that direction rather than simply trying to politicalize even this pious occasion also. Thank you very much, sir. Namaskar.
Thank you, Venkaiah ji. We now go to the listed speakers of the day, Kumari Mayawati ji.
माननीय सभापति जी भारतीय संविधान के मूल निर्माता परम पूज्य बाबा साहब डॉक्टर अंबेडकर की 125वीं जयंती के वर्ष पर भारतीय संविधान के प्रति प्रतिबद्धता को लेकर जो आज दूसरे दिन भी इस पर सदन में चर्चा चल रही है और इस चर्चा में हमारी पार्टी की ओर से आपने मुझे भी अपनी बात रखने का मौका दिया है इसके लिए मैं आपकी बहुत बहुत आभारी हूँ हालांकि मेरे बोलने से पूर्व तो माननीय सदन के नेता ने, प्रतिपक्ष के नेता व विभिन्न दलों के नेताओं ने और साथ ही 27 नवंबर को तो हमारे देश के प्रधानमंत्री श्री नरेंद्र मोदी ने लोकसभा में
नकवी साहब ने अपना नाम बता दिया,
तो इसके ऊपर काफी